NCTV45, The Train, anytime on your time.
So what that means?
Good morning. Welcome to the J&J Show.
Did he just threaten us?
No more live from downtown Newcastle. I'm done with that bit. Yeah, he was. He was
making fun of us. I think he was.
He's already starting off, like on Monday the 28th.
Yeah, you know what? Here we go
coming
again.
Coming at you.
Yeah, coming at you. Like, what do you mean?
Well, he's coming at you now.
Yeah, I don't know why. We didn't say anything. We came prepared.
His padula up.
Yeah.
Because it just seems to me that, like,
he
we
is
were getting
a little
ready
lower.
To start, and he was, like, out in the fog, and, you know.
As always.
What do you mean out in the fog?
You know,
where is Padula?
Well, anyway, you know
that
what?
A new attitude, like with your little thing.
Yeah, a little flavor saver.
Yeah, yeah. No.
Oh, hey, can we say that?
No, you cannot.
It meant food.
Well, nobody knows but that. No, that's all right.
My sympathy.
For what?
Yeah, my sympathy.
I'm all dressed in black.
No, I figured you guys wore black because last week I did cook in a castle. And you guys went down.
Yeah, no, there is no way. There's no way. Wow. You got to keep the amphetamines from him. Okay? You have to just put him in a safe place. Lock him up in a safe or something.
In a safe place.
Yes, please. Do that. Well, anyway, listen. Good morning. Welcome. It's September 28th, the J&J Show, all week, nonstop, coming at you on time, every time. Zip! How can they get in touch with us?
You can get a hold of us on NCTV45.com or NCTV45@gmail.com. And once again, you can contact the big man himself direct. And we encourage you to do so because it's always funny when he answers the phone during our broadcast at 724-510-7345. That number again, 724-510-7345.
And how about the Twitter?
You can tweet us or tweet us.
People have been, wow.
At James Joel, all one word, James Joel, NCTV45. And it's been blowing up.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I am so excited for this week.
Thank you, Confluence, for the coffee. As per usual, it is...
scrumptious.
Fantastic.
Scrumptious. And the biscotti.
Biscotti.
Fresh, I just get them, they're hot. I'm like juggling them, you know, because they're so hot. And Dixie, she sticks her apron up like this, and they all go into her apron, and she throws them up again.
No, she doesn't.
And I try to...
No, she doesn't. Oh, no.
I think that was my dream. I thought I was dreaming that she was
Does your girlfriend know about this?
About the biscotti? Yeah, absolutely.
About you dreaming?
About Dixie and the biscotti and flipping up in her apron? Absolutely. I share stuff like that with her all the time. Now, listen to me. I am so happy.
Speaking of Twitter.
No, wait a minute. What about it? Okay. But listen, I am so happy. You know why? And I'm pumped. You know why?
Why?
This week is Septic Smart Week. I am so pumped.
I'm pumped.
It's Septic.
No pun intended.
No, it's Septic Smart Week. Did you know that?
No.
In Pennsylvania, they have a week. And again, once again, when you guys are
Hold on. Just stop for a second.
What's wrong? What happened? Did I say something?
There we go.
Yes, I did say something.
Let's go ahead.
But anyway.
Septic Smart Week.
Yes.
And so you're celebrating poop.
Yes.
Oh, man. I didn't know the show
poop
would
is
come to this
never
level.
Not
We're not
funny.
Talking about poop.
Poop is always funny.
I'm just ecstatic because I waited for this all year. And wow, I can't
wait.
What?
You haven't gone to the bathroom in all year?
No, I have.
We knew that's why.
See, why is the show getting? What is this? Is the show? There's the bell. We eliminated the bell.
I know. He brought it back.
Poo talk.
Sucks back in.
I'm just speaking of sucking.
So, I don't want to be cut up.
Speaking of
he's been in Jared's pants.
And pumping, you could do that as far as, and they suggest and advise that you do that, I think, every year or two with your septic tank.
Yeah, because what can happen, and it brings me to a point that I've been not to get too serious, but it's been
about
on my...
About a septic tank? Yeah, you can't be serious.
You have to be serious about septic.
I'm very serious.
And this is why. It's been on my mind because it's a hot point. It's a big topic that's been in the media as of late. And no, it's not politicians. If your septic tank would happen to back up, and sometimes it does back up into people's homes, you don't get it taken care of, you can have a mold issue.
Oh, whoa. And I know where you're going
with
this.
Mold has been a hot point.
Oh, my gosh.
So I'd like to take the next 15 to 20 minutes, perhaps the next two or three episodes, and really dive in.
Yeah.
And thoroughly explore the
Ladies
mold
and gentlemen,
epidemic.
This is the J&J Morning Show. Okay, this isn't WKST with Ken Lobovey.
I'm sorry, that was a shot. I
was telling at our meeting this morning.
Yes,
we do a lot of research, and we're we are number one. And here's the reason why we're number one.
Still number one?
We are always.
You're following Cook and the Castle.
No, we are number one. But here's the thing. I listened to the competition because...
Hence why, if you do a number one, you should get your septic tank looked at.
let me explain to you. Let me explain to you what I
derailed.
I came prepared today, and I'm being... I'm being derailed.
Now you know how I feel on a weekly basis.
How can you feel like that?
Now, Joel, this is for you. I'm going to make you a hero at home.
Okay.
Here's what you do.
I'm always a hero at home.
Now you can make macaroni in the microwave.
I can't. But why would you even talk? I thought our plan off the side, we weren't going to talk to him this week. Now you're talking to him, and he's making
Kraft macaroni and cheese.
Yeah.
In a bowl.
You know, if you eat a lot of that stuff, you'll end up like a septic tank that hasn't been cleaned in 5 years.
Your girlfriend will think you're a great cook.
You don't want that feeling.
Okay, numero uno. Point number one.
Go ahead.
Numero uno.
Go ahead.
I do not have a girlfriend. We've established that fact.
Nobody even asked you.
And number two.
It's septic tank smart. Yes?
Yeah, it is okay. Septic tank smart.
And number three, if you watch a show.
If you eat with the golf balls, maybe they'll like it.
I don't.
Because you golf.
Man. What a way to start off September 28th.
Hey, my hammock's doing good.
You're what?
Well, we're bringing up old bits. We're rehashing old stuff.
I came prepared. And you know what? Ladies and gentlemen, fabricating, please look up Septic Smart Week. They give you tips on how often you should have the septic tank cleaned. I thought we're in Western Pennsylvania. I thought maybe people need to know that because maybe they forgot all about sometimes. You're sitting there eating dinner, and all of a sudden you're looking at each other, and...
How many
you're probably
times,
saying, hey, man, go to the bathroom
how
if you're going to flatulate.
You sit and eat.
Okay.
And,
so, and then you're looking at the other guy.
Poop.
And then, well, I'll tell you
we
when.
Don't do
you know when?
Table.
When we're watching cooking in a gas.
Hey! What
the
hell? But I mean, a barn.
Yeah.
How
yeah.
about your septic system? How is that right?
Well, but what I'm saying is that there's that little stench that comes along with it, and then you're all looking at each other, and then you're starting to shake it, and then all of a sudden, you should say to yourself, I should check out my septic tank instead
of. Just get some Ritex. There's this stuff called Ritex. It's like an antimicrobial bacteria that. Throwing out some big words.
Yeah.
That actually help clean your septic system.
Yeah.
Why are we talking about
this? Well, you know why? I'll tell you what, we're not. We're done. But I'll tell you who brought it to my attention.
You were super excited about it.
I am, and I still am.
Do you celebrate it at all?
I celebrate it, and the person that mentioned this to me, and
Septic
he's back
Sam.
On TV. No.
Septic Sam.
No, he's back on MSNBC. I'm so happy about him because they treated him as if he lived in a septic tank. Brian Williams is back.
Oh, he's back.
He's back on MSNBC. I am so pumped.
Well, he climbed Mount Everest. He broke the speed of light.
Yes. He cooked on Cook in a Castle.
Cooked on Cook in a Castle. What else did he do on his vacation? Well, not vacation.
Didn't
suspension.
He fight in the Iraq War, World War II? Didn't he have something to do with Hitler?
Well, he helped Al Gore found the internet.
Right.
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, and he's like this with the Pope on global warming.
Yes. Yeah.
So, but
he's and he invented TV.
It's really warm under that, cassock there.
So anyway, Brian Williams is back. I'm pumped. As pumped as
so
I am.
So it's been a great week. Great week for you. You got Septic Smart Week, and you've got Brian
Williams is
on.
Back.
It's back.
Yes. And right. Cooking a Castle, pray tell.
Is back.
Is back. So what did you...
So he's so happy.
I didn't get a chance to watch it.
Listen,
I didn't feel like
the,
it, but go ahead.
The big tip of this...
I've never seen an episode.
Neither have I.
Get a box of Penne.
Mr. Weller, I think, watches.
Put in two cups of water.
That's why he had all those problems last week.
The box of Penne, and you have macaroni in 13 minutes.
With his Castle.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
Yeah,
and you know what? That brings me to an interesting point. Listen. Let's reel this back in. It brings me to an interesting point. Last week, we obviously, if you were kind enough to watch last Friday's episode, you will realize that the last 5 minutes were us just losing it.
Right.
And we actually had some, when I was talking about speaking of Twitter, we had some reaction via Twitter. Actually, some of it was negative.
What?
Why would you guys make fun of your sponsors? But here's the thing. Mm-hmm. We're laughing with them, okay?
Right,
number
right.
one. Number two, no press is bad press, right?
Right, right.
And we're just having fun with it.
A lot of fun.
Instead of just reading Paul D. Weller of Weller. And,
yeah.
You know, it's
well, you saw Angela's commercials for Weller.
Well, Angela wasn't happy. I saw some of the reaction from behind the
glass.
He
wasn't even here. Remember, he walked out. No, he didn't walk out because of that. He walked out because they texted him about the upcoming Septic Smart Week.
Oh.
And Brian Williams, maybe they were going to co-host it. But mm-hmm. We do everything.
Brian Williams invented the septic tank.
He did. Mm-hmm. And listen to me. I
when
think
they opened it, they found out there was global warming.
So
and it was full of...
Right.
Like Brian Williams.
People are trying to eat breakfast. So
yeah, let's move on from second.
I am. So let's talk about
okay,
the sponsors.
Okay, let's talk about sponsors. The Lawrence County Football Show.
No, I don't want to talk about we'll that. Is it time?
I got mail in that
let's
wanted
go
to
talk
no,
about
we
it.
We
got to
respond
the
to this, these negative comments.
Okay,
can we respond?
Let's respond.
Here's what I'm... Go Scotties. Wait a minute. Go Scotties. Here's what I have to say. When I go out and speak with the sponsors...
Shenango's going to win it all.
They're undefeated. But the Scotties are going to make the playoffs. Anyway,
what's her name?
That's the one that got thrown from a Jeep.
She helped Al Gore.
She's got a job now.
Yeah, congratulations.
What is she?
She looks good.
Thanks for going out and getting her, Angelo.
Yeah, Darlene.
That isn't Darlene.
Come on.
When I meet with the sponsors, we get along very well. We have a nice relationship. Obviously, you see they give us the T-shirts. We've eaten. From some of the places. I shop at the places because they've been very nice, and that's what you do. But they know. If you're watching our show every day, you know we're not going to be serious about the sponsors. And you mentioned negative press, but it's not negative. It's just we're messing around.
Yeah.
It's fun. And,
that's what I meant.
And you know what? If they want to come on the show and poke fun at us, poke fun at us. But guess what? We're trying to make it exciting so that you go to these places. Hey, there's
your coach.
Coach.
Bucky.
Bucky. Hey, so anyway, buddy. So that's my take on it. So, but that's okay. And listen to me. You are entitled to your opinion on Twitter or Facebook or whatever. So that's fine with us.
Yep.
All right.
Okay,
so
now,
go ahead.
This question in.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Hot off the press.
It actually came from.
Oh, we're gonna let him take over for a minute.
Area in Phoenix. Several of the high schools out there, their football fields are a little bit bad. They were wondering if J&J could come out to a game so they could get rain.
That's all you got?
I'm just telling you, because you guys are wimps. You're always in the rain. Telling me,
whoa, let's reel this in.
Yeah.
How are we possibly wimps? We're the ones that endured
the rain,
a lightning storm, perhaps even a tornado, from what I've been told.
Right.
Mm-hmm. To report the lack of a Shenango football game.
Right, right.
Then we go to Laurel. It's nice everywhere else.
Mm-hmm.
The heavens open up at Laurel. How is that our fault?
Mm-hmm.
See, here's what you have to understand, Joel. You've kind of made the heavens upset because, after all, I don't watch much football, but when I watch football, I watch Notre Dame. You watch the state school,
Here we go.
Now, I haven't had any rain.
Here it goes.
You've had rain.
It's been three games.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Virginia, there is a Notre Dame.
Here we go.
And here we go. Folks. We have 3-0.
Three games.
So I just bringing that up. You know, they said, see if J&J can stop being all wet.
I'll be completely honest with you with the Notre Dame situation. First of all, I'm taking no responsibility for the rain. You sent us there. You sent us ill-equipped. We have no umbrellas, and then I find out after the fact that we have rain gear, NCTV45 rain gear. Did we get that? No.
We don't need it.
No, we just get sent out.
We're old school guys.
Secondly, I will concur with you on a bit about Notre Dame. If I were to vote for probably at least a one or a two right now, Notre Dame should be one or two.
No.
Because they've beaten some quality opponents and dominated and have kind of an Ohio State situation going on with losing their starting quarterback, starting safety, starting linebacker. One of their linemen went down. One of their offensive linemen
went down.
There's a few altar boys that are playing next
week. The team that should be number one is Michigan State. But that's neither here nor there.
Well, okay. That's what I'm saying. So, interchangeable.
So, Angelo, tell us about this Lawrence County. Is there a football show that we...
Yeah, there's a football show.
Every week, there's the Lawrence County football show.
You didn't know we were in this?
No, I thought he was just messing around.
He spliced it all together?
He was sleeping during the highlights.
Like the first week, he had the lightning and everything in the background, and he's spliced in our little bits. And then last week, he did the Aliquip band. And yeah, he spliced it all together.
How'd that come
up? Tell you what's coming up, what the games are of the week, so people can go out to the games. Potentially see you guys at your game.
Right.
And then I'm at another game.
Speaking of which, here's an interesting caveat to this whole situation.
Go ahead, please.
Us going out to the games. Mm-hmm. Can you describe to the folks out there what it's like for us to go out to a game?
Right.
You talk about being unprepared. Go ahead. And it's not us being unprepared.
Right. It's old school. We do what we got to do to make this thing work. We come up with the creative ideas.
Oh, I see how it is. Uh-huh.
Of course, it's time to wrap up.
Before we wrap up, I just want to say one thing. Laurel, Aliquippa, Shenango, Western Beaver, the teams we've seen, the parents, the cheerleaders, the band, the players, the athletic directors, we thank you. Great stuff.
Yes. Props to everybody for putting in the work and the effort, and they do it all because they love to do it.
That's right. So, and that's why they're having success.
And tomorrow, folks, we will proceed to throw Angelo under the bus.
See you tomorrow. Please join us, the J&J Show.
Bye.
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 Bye.